The reason for the contest is pride. But pride is about self-expression, in my opinion. So you are free to express yourself in whatever way. So no solid theme. But pride. The reason for the fashion contest is celebrating pride. This is Zulu Skunk, who's up first. Zulu Skunk, do you want to say anything about your look or just show it off? Oh, I'm going to leave my group real quick also. Well, this is just a loving ancestral a girl loving ancestral Altmer. This is the look from the back. I love the bat. Oh, I really like the... I thought it was a black dress at first, but it's actually a really, really deep red. That's really cool. Golden accents all the way through. Yeah, the tats really bring the look together. This is such a cool look. Eventually during this contest, just wait. I'm going to fall off, but I'm taking some screenshots as well. So yeah, this is Zulu Skunks, like mysterious Altmer. Got the white eyes, the golden accents. The tattoos are gold. You have this dark red dress and the bat. The pose is perfect. It's such a really, really like mysterious and kind of a little bit aloof look. It's gorgeous. It's really great, Zulu Skunk. Yeah, I think the cage on the face is fantastic as well. And I think the bat is a perfect pet for it. Love her and her bat. Yeah, she's mysterious. I love it. Take the minor adornment. Here, let's get really close. Yeah, we also have the earring. Here, this is a real big close-up. You have both the gold face cage here, and then on this side, it's accented also with gold, with the earring and the nose ring. Like, everything ties together so well, like from the sandals up to the jewelry. The gold works so well with the red. Especially the fact that the tattoos are gold, so they like shine off the sun. I love that. Yeah, I almost forgot to look super close. I'll make sure I look super close to the face. Yeah, that's great, Zulu Skunk. That's amazing. Yeah, definitely an Altmer. Very cool. Ooh, next up we got an Orsmer. Love that profile from the back. Yeah, I like to get this first profile shot. Love the choice of the horse, the pony. Yeah, let's get in closer now. Let's get a front look, get a full body look at him. Big, thick, muscly Orsmer. Is there anything you want to say about your character, Mr. Mouseheart? I just post it in chat and I'll read it out. Yeah. The single shoulder piece is a look, and I'm here for it. Do you even lift, bro? Yeah, that is a thick Orsmer. Love the stance. So real quick, Baklava, what you need to do to remove UIs, you just go to settings, controls, and this will be your keybinds. And if you scroll down to camera, there's UI on off. It starts not bound. So you just have to bind whatever key you want to UI on off. So I use numpad negative to do that. And now we can kind of get in closer. So Mouseheart's character is rocking that one shoulder pad. The blues. I like how the leather blues go into the faded blues of the pants. We got the Dremora belt buckle there, really kind of tying the like cloth and leathers together. We want to not hide the muscles. So we use the arm wraps. Yeah, there we are. Get that Mr. Clean pose. And let's get in real. Let's try to get in close without going through. I also like how the reds actually accent Mouseheart's eyes here, because like the red of the wraps and the shoulder and the fact that the character has red eyes work together. And then we have the leather circlet pulling back the braids. We got the silvers from the braids. The silver matches up on the circlet. The red eyes augment the reds and blues. And then the purples tie perfectly. The purples and dark blues tie perfectly into like the black and purple pony. What I also really like is Mouseheart's hair has got the braids in front and then it's kind of like dreads in back. And our pony here is the same. Its mane has braids in it too. So like super good selection of non-com pet to go with the look. Like, because it's not just the colors that match up, it's the hair. That's fair. That's fair. Beefiest dude in the room referred to as Mouseheart. Awesome. Yeah, I love the look because I wanted to look at the back. So the hair they chose also has big beads in back with a skull. I want to make sure I showed that detail off. But yeah, look at the purples. Like I said, everything ties together. I like how the colors kind of like, we start with the blues and we move up to like the more darkish, the burgundies and purples. And we have the reds at the top. So we rise from the blues through the purples to the reds, little metal accents throughout. Perfect. Great look. Another amazing look. Indoril, are you around? There we are. Next up, we have Indoril. Yeah, let's get some claps for Indoril. I like to get the back profile first. We're going to go ahead and we'll grab this back profile first. We got the green dragon. We got the greens and the browns. I love the leaf. It's cool to see it with the mount. We're obviously not counting the mount in judging, but it's really cool to see the mount tied in. It definitely fits the whole like green and scaly look you're going for here. I see the Dagoth Dance Redemption. And then if we look at it from the front, so like the the green leaf effect. So the character itself, lots of greens and blues. We're using that that hissed type of look. If you could unmount for me so I could take a better look at the costume, that'd be appreciated. I love the mount. I think the mount's perfect. I wanted to get in. So the character is really another thing. We're wearing the cool hat. We're wearing our Netch hat. It's very earthy. But I also like the skin choice because we got that. I think it's the hissed, one of the hissed skins. The character themselves is scaly, a scaly boy. So we got this whole like kind of draconic earthen theme. We got the leaves. We got the dragon. The character themselves is very earthy with the scales and stuff. Wearing the Netch is a hat. Very natural, very druidic kind of look. Got those shining red eyes that just pierce out from the rest of the outfit, but they don't take away from it because there is reds in the outfit. And then, yeah, around back, like a weapon even kind of ties into the same kind of earthy look. And I love the skin, the fact that the skin is orange, because I think the orange really complements the blues and greens of the outfit super well. Yeah, I dig the whole look too. Must be a warden. Got that earthy vibe. Yes, yes. So perfect. All right. Yeah, great look. Great earthy, great scaly, hissed warden look. All natural. Loved it. Really good job. Great job, Enderal. Another amazing look. That's what Pride's all about, is self-expression. Three great looks so far. Next up, let's take a look at 72 December's look. Here's December 72. Looks like their club loon is hanging back for some reason, but they have that white and blue club loon. Taking a look from the back first, we got the golden tattooed skin, a nice golden sword, lots of whites and wraps. And then if we move around to the front, our Dunmer here is wearing, yeah, just simple sandals with gold lacing, golden tattoos. The club loon is a white and blue bird. Those color schemes fits perfectly with the color scheme. If we get a little closer, we can kind of see like the reds and stuff that accent the outfit and the blues that accent at the top along with the golds. And then we have that golden wreath headpiece, golden nose piercing. And that gold really, I mean, the kind of the grayish skin of the Dunmer mixed with like the gold paint or the gold tattoos, the gold headpieces, the gold sword. I think the gray and the gold go super good together. We have the hair kind of parted back to really show off the headgear. And then, like I said, the blue and silvers from the neck piece match the little club loon like perfect. And yeah, the shoulders look great with the top. That's another thing. This everything works together super well. So it's got like that very like white cloth wrapped look and then accented with just like metals and jewelry. The hair does have like a pinkish hue to it. It'll like, here, let's do it on the nose ring side. Boy, we can really kind of appreciate the like hair. Very Egyptian. Yeah, I'd say it has definitely has an Egyptian look to it. Yeah, the outfit and the skin tone go so well together. I agree. I'm not sure. December would have to answer if the shoulder piece is from the what set that's from. But this is great. This outfit is super well put together. The colors, again, the color, especially even with the skin tone, goes super well. The club loon is a perfect pet choice for it because same whites and blues. Oh, Greek. Getting a lot of screenshots here. But yeah, I love it. I think the nose ring and the head piece is perfect too. Because that way you have the gold from head. And then as you go down through the tattoos, all the way down to the slippers. Very well done again. Yet another amazing outfit. Again, looking at the back, the same thing. You see the tattoos. It has a lot of revealed skin, which really lets you see the tattoos. And then the sword perfectly pairs with the rest of the outfit. It's gorgeous. Thank you, 72 December. Ezradil. Next up, we'll have Ezradil. All right. For this next look, my look is based around the Ace flag, using black and purple with white accents. The main piece is heavy imperial chest because of the diamond. Aces use the different card colors to signify ace varieties. The Ace of Diamonds referring to demisexual. I'm using the assassin stance to make a reference to how aces are very used these days to either have to hide or aggressively defend themselves, even within queer communities. On a brighter note, I've picked the white dragon for both its color and dragons being the chosen mascot of aces. Also, I brought cake because we like to do flag cakes for our community. Please pretend it's actually purple, not red. Awesome. Yeah, this is based on the asexual flag and specifically the demisexual variant of it. Very cool. Very cool. Yeah, we have the dragon for the reason stated. It's kind of the chosen mascot of aces. I'm waiting until the dragon flies back in because I want to make sure I get the screeny. All right. So from the back, lots of purples. So obviously we have the initial skin, the Khajiit skin, gray with black and brown rotating. That's the skin tone. And then we got the red diamond in the center. For the stated reasons, which ties really well into the weapon chosen too. Like the weapon fits the angles and the colors and the diamonds, like the diamond from the back and the diamond from the weapon work well together. We have that hairstyle again, the braids with the dreads, the skull beaten back, lots of different purples and red varieties that like blend together with the black super well. As we rotate around to the front, get a full view first, best we can. Also like the dragon's red eye works well with the diamond and in both the weapon and the armor. And then, yeah, we can see the purples. And then with the sun from the front, that's why I like looking at it from the back and then the front, because the way the sun works, you can see it kind of shine a little more from the front. And then we have the whites tie in. We have like the colors of the asexual flag. And then the face paint also with the reds and blacks, the face paint ties in really well to the outfit. And now let's get a little closer, look at some of the details. So like the shoulder, maybe a bit too close. Yeah, the pink, you got the pink string on the shoulder pads. The shoulder pads really detailed and work really well with the rest of the outfit. And again, like that hair has those awesome hairstyles. And then, so the between the skin and the accents, you get that white part. So I also love the belt choice, I think. Because like you said, you have a lot of diamonds. You have the red diamond there. You also have like the diamond of the belt. So you've really tied all of those like parts of the like the asexual flag and stuff into your look, I think, really expertly. That's a good side profile. It looks so good in the sun. Like I like the shiny metal parts because they accent really well off of like the parts, like the matte parts, the leather part and cloth parts that don't shine as much off sun. So like it has a really good contrast. Fantastic. Really, really great theme to it. Really great like story and why you made all the choices you made. Again, the white dragon works. The dragon's more white, but that's again, I love contrast. So like the white dragon, obviously contrasting, not just because of the mascot, but contrasts really well off the skin tone of your character and the white parts of your outfit. And then, like I said, the red of its eyes contrasts really well off the diamond parts of your outfit that are red. So I think it works super well together. It works really well with the pet. And that purple is gorgeous. Absolutely great. Another amazing, amazing outfit. Another amazing look. Thank you, Ezradel. Really, really appreciate that. Next up, we have Televia. Ooh, I always like to get this kind of view from the back. We're going with the Sovereign Guard Cub, so the white with the gold coming off of it. And then we can already look from the back of the outfit. We see the golden eagle staff, the white dress, very, very much already going together. But when we move around to the front, we can see a lot more of the gold coming through. And then even the way the sun reflects off the white, it's got that pearl, like that goldish pearl white sheen to it. We got the white leather, the whitish off-white boots with the gold accents. Again, golden tattoos work so good on the Altmer gray skin. Or sorry, not the Altmer, the Dunmer gray skin. I think super well. The Dunmer, yeah, sorry, I said Altmer. She snapped a look at me. Dunmer gray skin. Like, I think that gold contrasts so well with that skin tone. Again, we got the poofy sleeves. We got the off-white leather, the kind of pearlescent leather. And then if we get in, we'll get in really close here. I'm being too rude. Oh, I like the one black, one white eye look too. We got the golden wreath, got the kind of hair pulled back in the wreath so we can see the ear on one side and it's hidden by the hair on the other. We're using another nose ring. It's the crescent nose ring that has like the little moons that hang off of it as well. But yeah, the different whites and golds all accent each other. Like you can really see all of the gold accents in like the corset, the snaps and buckles, and then the leather really feels like it's holding the coat parts back. Like the choice of the bracers works super well with the poofy sleeves. Like I think feel it comes so well together with that collar. Collar really accents the face. And again, the gold tattoos on the legs against the gray skin works so well. And then I love the choice of the weapon with the big gold eagle at top, especially since you said your character's backstory is the Altmeri parents. Oh, and then we got our Azura thing. Let's grab that screeny. Great emote use, perfectly fits in. And then yeah, the cubs, that white and gold too. So everything ties together so well. You got kind of the Altmer connection with the eagle. Great, great look. So good. Thank you for sharing. That's another amazing, amazing look. We're using that new skin, that new skin. We're using the first, I love the construct, the reds and blacks already, like from the back profile goes super well together. We have the fire, the glowing red of the Dwemer construct. And the golden Dunmer goes too. So then if we get closer. So the new Deadland skin that we got in quarter one, I love how it shines. Like the red really pops through and brings out like the black parts of the outfit. Again, another the staff pairs in really well with the overall look. Oh, and then we're using those spider kith eyes, those glowing red eyes which almost always look good in my opinion. Okay. Oh. Love it. Loving the variety. I timed out on Xbox fishing. Watching the fat. Oh no. But yeah, so use those with your stuff too. Awesome. Anyway, Harley Quinn's thing I want to read real quick is, my character got a little corrupted by Daddy Dagon. She likes her new skin and enjoys showing it off. Also, recently has been practicing with the Wiccan magic, but keeps backfiring for some reason. Oh, and then we're using the Oh no! I told you. I knew it was going to happen at some point in this contest. Yeah, that's a great mount. Even though we're not weighing mounts into the overall like judging, is a really cool, really well fitting mount. I love how the red skin and the red eyes glow so much. So the whites and the blacks of the outfit really, really stand out against the red skin. I love the reds, the blacks. Definitely fits into that being corrupted by Daddy Dacon. The use of the flaming kind of like a Dwemer pet also ties in. Lots of fires, bright reds. And definitely that magic works in with the outfit choice, like the hissed outfit. And then, yeah, obviously you got your fire staff there. And I love the boots too, with the black and the silver. Again, the silver accents all around the black help, like basically the red and the black contrast really well. And then the silver helps it like really stand out against it. And let's get a close up of the face like we like to as well. So we can see the adornments choice. Oh, and so yeah, it's kind of covered a bit by the hair, but it shines through the like reds and silvers of the headpiece. And again, the silver is a really good choice. Just like the silver helps the black stand against the red, the silver helps separate the red of the gems from the red of the skin. And just kind of brings everything really together. Awesome. Especially, I love that new Deadland skin too. Definitely tying into the everything. Here, we'll take another back profile as well. Great, great look. Just a little corruption. When we look at our back profile here, we have that kind of black ghostly wolf with the purple glow from the purple eyes. Because we're looking at a purple and black outfit. So again, really good pet to character look. Purples, blacks, whites, again, looking at those ace flag colors, which is awesome. Amazing choice. Bubbles represent the dragon and common mascot of the ace community. Cool. Awesome. Glad to see two different outfits representing the ace community today. That's really, really cool. All right. So yeah, love the ace representation. This is our second. Ezra also representing the ace. We have our purple. So this is our back profile. If we spin around to the front, we get like the in the sun look. There's that dragon belt buckle representing that dragon mascot of the aces. I love the whites. I love how the metal pieces are that stark, like a bonish white. I don't know the technical white, but yeah, I love the bone white because the bone white pairs so well against the black and the purple, creates that really magical contrast. I also love the purple glow from the eyes of the pet. So then keeping kind of with the dragon thing, I know the belt represents dragons, but using those bone shoulders, I think really ties well into the rest of the accoutrements, like the dragon belt buckle, the knotwork pieces, and the shoulders tie in really well. Colors are spot on, purples, blacks, whites. And then let's go ahead and get in close. We have like little makeup under the eyes against that golden skin, the Altmeri golden skin. I like the fur collar. It looks really regal. Oh, okay. Cause yeah, it's got the fur, it's got the sashes. I love the different textures. That's something I could have talked about on the other outfits. It really also stands out here. The different item choices, because all of the items are gonna have different textures. So you have the padded legs, you have the sashes and the fur collar. And I love the textures because you can imagine how those would look like with real clothes. Draping, that's the term. It's the outfit drapes well. You have the poofy collars, the sashes over kind of like the tighter leather pieces. Then the pants poof again and are held together by the gloves and the legs. It drapes really well. The colors again go super well together. They represent that ace community super great. We're using the hair. We're pulling the hair back behind the ear so we can get that really nice movie star side profile. But also on the other side, we can get, you know, that swept hair look. It's a good look. The bone shoulders go super well with the knotwork pieces and especially with the dragon belt buckle, I feel. But yeah, great outfit again. Amazing choices. That's it for entries on EU before we go to NA. But what I would like us to do is I love the bow too. Good job. Why is this my bartender? So many. Yeah, everybody's look was outstanding good. Maybe get a little bit of a dance party going on before we leave EU. I could film that up. Let me switch. I'll even switch our song up real quick. Look at this group of people. Look at this EU group of people. We saw so many amazing outfits. Every single person had such an amazing outfit And everybody, honestly, all the other outfits I'm seeing around here, even the ones who didn't enter the contest, look amazing. Look how cool we look. Happy Pride, everybody. Yeah, you can come on NA again. That's fine, Telavia. I don't mind. This is where we
release the party.
So for this one, Telavia says, so this one got bitten by Mephala's spider as a child, and now she's embracing the dark goth life. We'll get our first. We like to get the fashion. We're going to go ahead and get this rear profile. We got dark reds, silvers, and blacks. We got that hairstyle braided back, silver accoutrements, really good. Got the red tattoos. The characters are different heights, so it's throwing me a bit from my EU character versus my tall NA one. All right, so the front we have, again, we have those black tight wrapped boots, tight black pants, goth, like the toga style tunic held together by the red cords, black bracers, a lot of blacks and silvers. We're using the Spider Kith eyes here again. Another person used the Spider Kith eyes, and the red eyes really, really tied, especially with the Mephala connection. And I see, yeah, we see your bat off to the side. I didn't see your bat at first, but there's your bat. And I really like how the bat is like the kind of the translucent style color. So it really ties in with your hair. But yeah, the boots, really like the laced boots. As we kind of go up, we can see the silvers as they accent off of the tunic. What I really like is the pale skin, how it accents off black so well, and the red that makes the red tattoos really stand out on the outfit. And then we get the reds, like that metallic red from the staff. And then for adornments, we have like just in right in with the hairline, we have that like red circlet, and then the pierced nose with the chain that goes over to the earring here. And then we have the silver off the choker. So yeah, another amazing look. And then yeah, let's get a side profile here. And I really love the use of the shoulders because it really ties together. It really ties together. I like the gold in the hair too, like the little golden accents in the hair and in the braid, I think really help tie the rest of the look together. And I like how the gold hair like ties off how the gold kind of glistens off the metal. All in all, another fantastic look. Really ties into that Mephala theme. Definitely a minion of our spidery Daedric prince. All right, so the pets sometimes don't want to catch up, but we have the black and white, kind of the panda colored bear there. Love bears. And if there's anything you want me to read about your character, just post it in chat and I'm happy to read it as well. Very stark, shiny silvers. What I love about the silver of the bow and the silver of the outfit and the gauntlets is you're using that like glowish, that light blue glowing tattoo, and the blues from the tattoo work so well against the silvers and whites of your outfit. Let's get that solid Nord front profile going. I'm trying to get your bear in the shot there. There we go. This is my Viking hunter, Ragnar. Very hunter, very Viking. I love the metal on the boots, not to be like, not understated at all. You can see the armor protruding at the top of the boots as well. You have your strong like leather armors. Again, the metal shines so brightly in the sun. And I think the metal works so well with that tattoo or with that skin. And like the red and black tattoos mix in so well, like the mixture of like the tattoos, the silver, like metal with the like kind of like that earthy brown. You have the hunter, like the wolf head, like definitely a hunter look there. The pierced nose I think works so well. Seeing the same circlet we saw in the last character, and it's so different. It's so awesome how different adornments look different on different characters. Like very strong, very powerful. We got that new long beard, which is so great for like Nords and other characters. We have that beautiful long beard. Again, if we look down at the gauntlets, they have that understated brown, but the metal just pops. It makes the metal and the tattoos pop so much that you use the brown, like the edges of the bow. Everything about it screams, you know, hunter. It's great. Yeah, true hunter. Indeed, Chatty Feather. Direct from Valhalla. Agree, Noctis. Direct from Valhalla. Or in the case of ESO, straight from Sovngarde, as it were. Next up is Soldieron. So we're going to get the pet and the back profile first. So we have that red and gold, the feathered serpent, which here, let's actually get the back profile from this angle. Yeah, that's good. We can already see how the colors of the serpent tie into the colors of the outfit. And again, if you want me to read anything, Soldieron, just post it in chat. And then yeah, the back profile here, again, just like the feathered serpent, we have that like brass, that goldish brass using the clockwork staff look, solid gold boots, or sorry, brass boots with the gold accoutrements. This is my lesbian vampire healer. Nice. Yeah. We got the gold accoutrements on the brass boots, the blacks and the reds. And so our back profile, we can see the red mohawk. Oh, let me turn this back off. The red mohawk. Already the color scheme works really well. So coming around to the front, getting the whole front profile, it's basically a... there at that angle. The snake, the golds and reds of the snake, basically perfect match. We have the red feather tips that match the mohawk, the golds and the brasses of the feathered serpent. And then from the front, like the back was really black, and the front, the black just really adds accent to the shining outfit. Brass, again, very shiny brass outfit. Oranges and brass, like sunset. Actually, that's what it reminds me of. This outfit reminds me of a sunset, which I think is fitting for a vampire. The gold... Using the gold against the orange, even though the orange is such a striking color, the gold pops against it, and the black just really draws everything out. Using those faded red tattoos, the Oblivion tattoos, work super well to kind of work in with the oranges and reds you're using. And then, yeah, the eyes also. The eyes match the outfit perfect. I like the snake bite piercings. I think the piercing works super well. Same kind of color scheme there. Blend perfect with the rest of the outfit. And again, the black just makes everything pop. Plus, it gives you that really defined neckline. I love how the shoulders are cut out so you can see the tattoos. And then the neckline is V'd out, which really like frames the face and frames the rest of the outfit so well. She looks really good. This is one of my favorites so far. It is very good. Yeah, and again, the colors of the staff work in perfectly with the rest of the look. And then if you look at the coloration of this pet, and then you look at the coloration that Ron used on the outfit, everything blends so well. I love it. I love the gold. I love the oranges. I love how it looks like a sunset. Everything goes together so well. What a great, great lesbian vampire. Amazing, Ron. Really, really great job. Love it. All right, next up, as I said, this is Necromnius. Necromnius using the Ouroboros crate cat, with that striking bright red on black. And then Necromnius's outfit, as you can see from our rear profile here, very striking reds as well, accented with blacks, and then some kind of off reds and silvers. Let's go ahead and move around to the front. All right, another, this is the second person we've seen using the Deadland skin. The Deadland skins and the Spider Kith eyes, basically the exact same eyes as the pet, the same kind of markings as the pet. And again, that this Deadland skin shines so well. Very good Dramora or Daedric look. We got the hard, like the deep reds that you get on leathers with blacks accenting it. And then the lighter reds that you get from like the quilted cloth and the cloth. I've said this on other outfits, it drapes really well. Like the way the cloth kind of drapes on the body, how everything kind of flows. And then how the cloth feels like, because you have a poofier sleeve, it gets tied off by the bracers. And then you kind of see these extra like black leather accents on the cloth. So again, straight out of the Deadlands with this one. So Sheena Vina, the reason for the contest is pride. But pride is about self-expression, in my opinion. So you are free to express yourself in whatever way. So no solid theme. But pride, the reason for the fashion contest is celebrating pride. All right, so next up, this is Riosh. Good morning. All right, so we have Riosh here. Riosh is using... Oh, we had these things for years and I can't remember their names. The magic things from the area we're in. Indrik. Maybe Indrik. Very iridescent purples, shining white. And as you can see from their outfit. And again, if you want me to read anything, Riosh, I'm not comfy enough with my masculinity to wear dresses and makeup IRL. So I put them on my beefy boys in games. That's awesome, Riosh. So yeah, this is Riosh showing off dresses and makeup because not comfortable enough IRL, but the game. And that's a wonderful thing about the game. So we're going to, so the pet, we can already see how the iridescence work well between this pet and Riosh. And let's go ahead and get closer. This is our back profile for Riosh. Beautiful, beautiful dress. Pinks, blues, and whites. Those very shiny pearlescent colors. I think they work super well. Again, the same colors you see with the beautiful Indrik there. And I think they frame really well on big masculine frames. I really do. So let's take a look from the front. Make sure we get your pet in the background there. Yeah, it does. Look how well that frames. Look how well the dress drapes. It drapes so beautifully on the orcish frame. I love how it drapes. Here's something that I think is really cool about Orsmer and these like beautiful, beautiful like colors, these trans flag colors, is Orsmer can have these really and you have it here, this really deep green olive skin. It's this dark, like gorgeous green. And that olive green, when you pair it, it just pops. Like it's that contrast again. It contrasts so well against the bright colors. So you have like the dark black tattoos, the olive skin, and then the broad shoulders. I love the color choices. I love the gold. I think the gold frames so well. The gold lacing works so well against the other colors. And the gold lacing, even though it's a little brighter, I think it works so well off the olive skin. And then as we get closer to look at the adornments, we have that gorgeous purple lip color. Look at that purple. That purple pops so well off the olive skin. The olive skin's already a gorgeous olive. And then that purple just pops. And then you have, like, if you look right under the eyes, same purple. So like the makeup, you have the really strong Orsamer style. So you still got the labrum piercing. You got the septum piercing. So you have the strong representation, that strong orcish representation, and that beautiful coloration. And then the pink flowers, obviously they tie into the rest of the outfit, frame the face so nicely. I love the contrast here. I love how the purples, the pinks, the blues, how that those trans colors and the Indric like pop. And I love how it frames. I love how the broader shoulders of the character make the dress drape, like, cause it drapes in, like it V's out and does that kind of Dorito kind of drape down in. Gorgeous, gorgeous character. Oh, I almost forgot to take a screenshot of the close-up. All right, so we had 9 looks on EU and 18 looks on NA. I know we had a couple people do 2, but the fact that we got a look today at 27 different looks, 27 fashions is amazing. So something we did on EU I'd like to do here. If I could get everybody who's still present to give me a slash dance maybe. He knows what he's doing. So good. So intense. Yeah, I love this. Dunmer and Rhaegar making love child now. I think so, Dr. Saints. I think so. I love Understand. Makes you look harder. It definitely does, Bunnykins. Definitely does. I'm going to recap and reshow all this amazing fashion. God, we saw so many cool looks. Look at all these. They're all so different, but everybody did such cool stuff. Jet drinks blood through the ear and does not dance. It's fed up with this shit. Oh, cool. Like I said, even the people who didn't enter, like, just have awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody. Thank you, one and all.